Okay, today we're going to talk about cube. This is an interesting one, so I want to show you all the little differences. First, we're going to type cube, open and close paren, open and close square bracket, 0 comma 0 comma 0. What this actually means is that it's length, width, and height. Or another way of thinking of it is X, Y, and Z in the Cartesian plane. So we're going to end this with the semicolon, and I'm going to show you an example first of a cube 10 by 10 by 10 that we're going to render. So it's 10 by 10 by 10. In order to center it, we would say comma after the closed square bracket. Type center equals true and then re-render it. Now, what's happened is it's exactly within the center of the Cartesian plane. So it's five above and five in each direction from there. So if you type false and re-render it, it's back to where it should be. So, a way of thinking of it is like this. You have a cube that has a width, a depth, and a height, and then you have the option to center. So, another way to think of it is this. If we don't want it centered, we can also do this and then re-render, and that'll put it back in the place where it starts from zero. So now I'm going to talk about how to do movement of the cube. So in order to move it, we're going to type translate, open and close paren, open and close square bracket, 0 comma 0 comma 0. We're going to indent this because it's part of it, and then in order to see how it moves, if we do this, it'll be the x direction that it moves in. If we do this, being 10 in the depth, then it will move in the y direction. And if we add 10 again and then hit render, it'll actually be up in the air by 10. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.